All right, guys. So when my partner has his shell up, again, the elbows are in, the chin is down, shoulders cover the jaw. Everything is protected except the low line. And of course, there's parts of his body that is open. The person that shelves, they're looking for you to throw a committed shot. They roll that punch off their shell. So Jabe's gonna close his shell. And let's say I commit to a shot. Now I'm open. He's just gonna fire back. Boing. So when someone shells, you just tap at it and move. Because if you overcommit, they're waiting for that so they can counter you back really hard. So again, the low line's very open. His knees, you could oblique kick, groin shot, etc. Okay, his face is obviously not open. His body is open, so I can tap, flare to his body. I can frame here and trap, jut. Okay, add my trapping. I could jut here, open up his defense. And then you have more of a Philly shell where I can close my center line, smother him, and fire body shots here, and have my head on the outside. This is an outside slot where, again, if I'm here, I'm just exchanging with him. So I'm more bladed, firing body shots, finding openings. And again, if we're doing foul tactics, I can add that in as well. Okay, so when someone shells, yes, it is a good defense to protect your face, but there's a lot of areas that are open. And also your hands are stuck to your head. So I could also, if I'm a grappler or fight more with totality, I can throw to his hands for about a second, change levels, and get a double leg takedown. Okay, so with totality, you can't just do the shell. You've seen it in MMA a lot. Some guys do it, but now it's getting more popular with guys like Sean Strickland, more of a Philly shell where you can also see more on what's going on. One more. So we were talking about defeating the shell, but if someone likes to shell and truck forward, they're trying to get in on you. Again, pull you on the inside, get real close to land, vicious shots to your body, to your face, trying to take you out. So what I was doing was keeping my defense super tight, taking the impact on my arms, keeping my arms really strong, my hands attached to my head, where again, if you see someone that doesn't know how to shell, they shell very poorly, and this gets hit, and then they hit themselves in the face. It looks like the Three Stooges. So again, this is super strong, super attached, and you're trucking your opponent, and you just want to viciously attack them on the inside. But again, it's a partial truth. If Jacob shells, and he's trucking me forward, I can use speed tactics. If I understand the shell, I can also break the shell. If I'm afraid, and I use speed tactics, and he's just trucking me, now I'm like super timid, I get too big here, I don't know what to do, then he's gonna attack me viciously. So you have to understand the shell to counter the shell. Okay, so again, for the most part, what happens is I truck my opponent, I stay super tight on my defense, I show up his attacks and I fire back. But like we said, to counter the shell, if he has a good shell, you tap it, you find different openings, his body, his legs. And again, if you're a grappler, you can just tap his head and take your double leg, put him on his back. So some people will say, what about your body? So if you're blocking to your body with the shell defense, you crunch, you bring your elbow towards your hip, you stay super small, you don't drop your hand like this, the way it's poorly done. The way a pro will do it, he has his shell tight, he drafts, makes himself small, bends his knees, absorbs the impact, fires back. If Jacob throws his left hook to my body, look at the line that's open, bang, that uppercut is there. If he throws his right hook to my body, look at the line that's open, that uppercut is there. So again, if you're doing the shell, you're super tight, chin is down, shoulders are high, your arms are super strong, your wrists are curled outward, okay, your hands are attached to your head, and you're doing small, quick motions, taking the impact on your arms and firing back viciously with power.